Welcome to this scenic overlook, where a class of would-be potion masters are hard at work on assignments of questionable safety. With their help and the help of their surroundings, we will learn all about the mechanical and electrical events of the heart. Collectively, these events make up what is known as the cardiac cycle and cover everything from the start of one heartbeat to the beginning of the next. Given all that happens in what is typically less than a second of time, it can be helpful to start by breaking this cycle down into two basic parts. Diastole, the period of time during which the ventricles are relaxing, and systole, the period during which the ventricles are contracting. These can be further subdivided into seven distinct phases, which we will walk through one at a time while looking at various changing parameters. This includes left ventricular pressure and volume, aortic pressure, left atrial pressure, the venous pulse, and the timing of the heart sounds. With all that out of the way, let's dive in. The first phase of the cardiac cycle is atrial systole. This phase is directly preceded by the P wave on the ECG, which represents the electrical activation or depolarization of the atria. It also happens to look a little bit like this rounded bush in the background. Note, going forward, each part of the ECG will be illustrated on this horizon line. This depolarization is translated into atrial contraction, which causes atrial pressure to rise and blood to be forced through the AV valves into the ventricles. This is sometimes referred to as the atrial kick, hence this kicking horse, and represents the final phase of ventricular filling, which corresponds with a slight increase in ventricular volume. Believe it or not, this horse is kicking because he used to be human. I wish I could say he's the first intern to suffer from being turned into a horse, or any animal for that matter, but actually, given my NDA, which I signed in triplicate and with ink that was derived from my own platelets, I've probably said too much. Moving on. In the right heart, the increase in right atrial pressure will also be transmitted back to the veins, where it will appear as the A wave on the venous pulse curve. This rounded mountain peak with an A-shaped gust of wind above it mimics this part of the curve to help you remember this. During this phase, the fourth heart sound, S4, may also be heard. It is thought to be caused by vibrations produced from the atrium contracting and pushing blood into a stiff or non-compliant ventricle. S4 is sometimes called an atrial gallop, which is why it is depicted here by the heart sound-like lines generated from this horse, kicking over a super stiff S4 chair. If S4 is heard, it is always considered abnormal and may be indicative of ventricular hypertrophy. The next phase is isovolumetric ventricular contraction, which begins during the QRS complex. See this QRS-like tree in the background. This represents the electrical activation or depolarization of the ventricles and translates directly to ventricular contraction and an increase in ventricular pressure, but with no change in volume. This mage is holding down the top of this bubbling cauldron to help you remember this. Like isovolumetric ventricular contraction, this will increase the pressure inside, but keep the volume of potion unchanged. This is possible because as the ventricles contract, the rising ventricular pressure will force the AV valves, the mitral and tricuspid, closed, which produces the first heart sound, S1. The heart sound-like lines coming from this corked bottle should help you remember this. Since the semilunar valves, the aortic and pulmonic, are also closed at this point, each ventricle will be closed off from the rest of the cardiovascular system, so no blood will be ejected and the ventricular volume will remain unchanged.